I'm Sir Tap Tap, and welcome back to Legend of Dark Witch 1. I like Blad's design. I guess it's a lot like a certain character from a certain popular anime. I'm not sure if this was... No, this was probably after Kill La Kill. But, I really like that little highlight in her hair there. She's got a good outfit, too. Like I said, the... Scratch in my eye. I really like the visual design of the characters. It's everything's a little bit simple in this first game, but it really comes together in game two. I really want to show off game two, but I can't right now. I think this has gone a lot faster than I realized, so I think I'm going to do a normal difficulty run of the second character. I forget her name. It's a different person in game two, I think. So the person whose name I want to say, I don't think is actually it. Oh, and let me talk a bit more about Game 2. So in Game 2, the shop is way bigger. Like I said, there's higher levels of, you know, you can buy even more health or even, damn it. Even higher amounts of Trez to get. And there's also... Oh, the biggest change. Well, one of the bigger change... Oh. Well played, game. It's one of those things you just sort of have to know it's coming. So as you can see, I died finally, and that removes all of your install bar, which dying is a pretty big deal in this game because of that install bar. Because, you know, it's sort of the opposite of Mega Man that way, actually, because in Mega Man, a lot of times, if I have low health before I go to the boss, I'll just die on the boss, because, you know, I have, you know, lives, I'm not going to beat the boss at, you know, 3 health. But in this game, I guess that sort of solves a problem with Mega Man, now that I think about it. But in this game, you know, you have these power-ups built up, and if you die on the boss, you lose them. So, it's actually quite beneficial. I have a feeling there's a Sega around here. Oh, another nice thing about the hidden Segas in 2 is that you can just walk near them. A lot of them are designed for you to just... physically bump into them. I'm really bad. So here we're getting some decent difficulty. I'm bad at dealing with those hedgehogs that explode. Crap, what was I talking about? It's interesting that the difficulty makes it so that if you want to get to the boss fully powered up, and you want to not die on that first challenge, because it's a lot harder if you, but you'll have full health if you die on the boss. I mean, it's totally possible, but you need to, you know, have really good dodging skills. Or, you know... I actually haven't seen how severe the handicap on bosses is if you use the, you know, right weapon against them. Like I said, that's not really... So there's stuff down here. I need to see if there's a Sega down here. There we go. Any sort of optional path. Ugh, that's so annoying. Usually has one. Is that the power one? Oh, it's Comet. Actually, that's good. We're using Comet. Actually, Liner is probably the better one to use to search out Sega for a first playthrough. Damn it. Also, another thing about Game 2, you can choose what you upgrade with the Sega. You can unlock... Damn it. See, this game has difficulty in it, see, I promise. Yeah, you can choose what you do with your Sega. Instead of, in this game, you know, if you want to level up your power, you just have to know which hidden Sega actually gives you power, which, you know, you're going to need a guide for. In game 2, you can just collect any and, you know, purchase whatever you want most. And in game 2, you can also upgrade... Damn it. See, the general true difficulty in this game is any enemy that can knock you into a pit. Let's actually beat Stoge first. Isn't Stoge, like... That just seems like a very manly man for this, you know... tiny fairy girl. But whatever. I'm also not entirely sure what this, like, Aurora sequence is supposed to be like. I guess she's, like... It's this game's version of, you know, Mega Man teleporting in. Zizu's some kind of like god, actually. I forget if the... I hope that's not a spoiler. I forget if this game introduces her like that. That's kind of what we're doing here. Oh, like, here's the difference. These crabs, in normal difficulty, they spit out bubbles when they get hit. But in this difficulty, they just, you know, die. So, I guess Blad's stage is less affected by the difficulty downgrade than other stages. Because the, ow. Take that green crystal. Love those rats. Or not rats, the cat things on umbrellas. It's a very Kirby enemy. So the backgrounds look very simple in this game. They're a lot better in the second one, in my opinion. I forget what that does exactly. I guess maybe those hurt? The fire things hurt? I forget. Like I said, it's been a little while. I was expecting to do worse, because it's been a while since I played this one. But I guess easy is easier than I thought it would be. I say as I have one health. But yeah, I really like how this game, the difficulty affects enemies' timing and stuff. So enemies actually get a lot more brutal, and not just because, you know, higher health, more damage. Then you can't deal more damage because, you know, you have very few hit points. But still, you know, it's not a lazy difficulty system, and most difficulty systems are lazy, to be quite blunt. I see you. Zombie shrooms. Yeah, the shop system in 2 is really great, and there's even consumable items that, like, I actually really like how the second game does consumables, because, come back here. Yay! One annoying thing, they actually didn't really fix this in the second game either. If you have a full bar, and you have stuff like we can't upgrade speed, even though our bar is actually full here. Normie, get out! So one of the plot points is the Fae can use magic without Sega, and humans need Sega to use magic. So that's why they went missing. But yeah, because my install bar is full, I actually have to take a hit or I can't upgrade anything below my current level. Oop. Rude. Oh, frick. Well, now we're gonna get to see a boss with, Oh, I thought it dumped your whole bar. But, ow. Rookie mistake. You can also get a small amount, well, actually not a terrible amount, of, install bar power mid-boss fight, because each time you hit him, you get a little bit of Trez. Ow. It's kind of silly how much better everything is, honestly, in the second game, because, like, even the, you know, new skill get screen is a lot better. It's, like, animated and more... Oh, we have a lot of tries. It's just probably more stock because I keep. Did I max that out? Yeah. I'm not used to it being so easy to max things out. You need a lot of Trez to max everything out in the second game. Like, that's why it's a good idea to start on the higher difficulty in the second game, because you can pretty much grind the difficulty down to whatever you want, but, you know, it makes low percent runs a lot more rewarding that way. Because you beating Lunatic with maximum, you know, having bought everything, is like a ton easier than you know, not buying anything at all. Especially not using the install bar. That would be, I think, is that a challenge in this one? I don't think it's a challenge in two. But that would certainly make things a lot harder. But it's certainly possible. One thing I really like in Mega Man ZX Advent, it's professional difficulty. It's like how difficulty is handled in this game. Enemies deal more damage, take less damage, but they also, their attacks, you know, say an enemy shoots one bolt in easy, they'll shoot two bolts in normal and three in professional. And so not only are their attacks harder to dodge because, you know, there's more area of effect or whatever, the damage is also pretty tightly calculated in Mega Man ZX to make sure that if there's any one attack you are completely unable to dodge, you will probably die. Like, each enemy has a desperation attack, and if you can't dodge that, it's gonna deal enough damage to you that you'll probably die. Or if there's like, if an enemy uses one attack that you just can't dodge at all, and it uses that twice even, I think you could die. And that game, I'm talking Mega Man ZX Advent, not this game. But that game restricts, in professional difficulty, it greatly restricts your healing items, and, you know, there's no health upgrades. So everything's pretty well tuned for, you know, you actually having to learn the boss fights. And Mega Man Zero had its own way of sort of enforcing that you actually know boss difficulty, like your boss difficulty, you know their patterns. Because you can only take so much damage and still get a perfect score. Like, you can take, like, one hit from a boss and get, actually, I'm not even sure if you can take even one, unless it's a really weak hit, and still get 100 out of 100. But, to get an S rank, you need to take very little damage. I actually all S ranked all four Mega Man Zero games. I was meaning to do a Let's Play of those a long time ago. Not entirely a fit with my channel lately, but, you know, I don't really limit myself. Like, I don't tend to show off AAA sort of games, if you can even call, you know, I know Capcom's definitely AAA, but, I'm not sure the Mega Man Zero series is what most people would consider AAA these days. Definitely fantastic games, but, you know, not stupid high-budget Space Marines. Snazzy clothes. You might notice there's some minor localization stuff. I'm not sure if one of the developers like speaks a little bit in English on the Twitter, or whoever runs their Twitter account. It's kind of just strong enough to be endearing. I really don't have a problem with, you know, for this game's obvious budget, I don't really have a problem with, you know, the minor typos and stuff. It's just cute, honestly. Like that ahoge of power she's got going on there. Also, one interesting thing, most enemies have a little red outline. This makes them a teeny bit more easy, you know, to stand up against the background stuff. Crap, what was was I gonna say? I was gonna say something before though, they started talking. I like this boss. Nope! I forgot about that part. I forget if invincibility is longer, or if enemies definitely take a lot more hits. Damn it. On higher difficulties. But you can definitely get hits in more frequently than most Mega Man bosses will let you. Ah, damn it. Another thing to forget is if you die, you also lose your wing and your speed ups, which can be problematic for certain boss fights. We'll be fine here, though. Ow. Barely. Barely fine. But still fine. As you can see, we're gaining money a lot faster because of all those Trez upgrades. I haven't used any of the special weapons. I'm sorry. I'll try to show those off. Is this the... I forget if this is the final thing or if there's one more after it. But we're getting darn close to the end here. We should finish this in this video. So yeah, divide ice. Not very useful against normal things. And as you can see, with pretty much none of these are super useful against normal enemies except for this thing. As a sort of barrier. Whatever. What else we got? Bound ring. Yeah. I find the weapons are a lot more generally useful in the second game. Also, did they patch this? Oh, they did. In the 3DS version, Dia missile, if it didn't hit a target, it would actually increase your install meter. Instead of, you know, not costing anything. I guess, oh crap. They obviously fixed it for the PC version. Oh, also, let me just say, how cool is it that we are... Okay, so for context here, this is, you know, down. You can adjust the camera up and down by, you know, pressing up or down. I just haven't been thinking of using it. So this is a doujin game, you know, a Japanese indie game for 3DS, you know, not only on Nintendo's... The platforming in this last area is a lot harder than most of the earlier stuff. So we've got a Japanese indie game on a Nintendo console on a portable ported to PC. Like, no two of those things would have made sense before this generation, let alone all of them. So that I'm pretty dang optimistic about this generation personally because of stuff like that. There's definitely some crappy stuff regarding Nintendo in general, pretty glad that, you know, I mean, just every aspect of this makes me happy, like, Japanese devs making game, or, you know, Japanese indie devs making games in general, always great, but also being able to make it on console, digitally, you know, not having to, you know, make a certain amount of units, then fail to sell that many units, and then die, like, you know, GameCube stuff. And then also being able to port, you know, portable games to PC. Like, how many frickin'... Aw, damn it. You really should look up and down in this level. I'm just not, because I'm stupid. Lost my train of thought. On easy, this is where the difficulty really ramps up because, you know, I don't think easy fixes, or not fixes, but I don't think easy actually does anything to the platforming in this game. In the second game, if you pick the absolute easiest difficulty, a lot of the platforming challenges are lessened or removed because it adds assist blocks, sort of like the Mega Man ZX games and Mega Man 10 and maybe 9. I forget if 9 does it too. Think so? But yeah, I kind of like that idea that the assist blocks, because I mean, difficulty usually doesn't really affect platforming, which is how you get to situations like this where it's a lot harder. I don't mind it being harder, because, you know, I was kind of hoping this would be harder than it was. Alright, so look down. I knew that was coming too. So this little hook jump is kind of rude. Aw, damn it. Because if there's an enemy down there, it would say danger, but it doesn't do that for pits, which is kind of misleading. Oh, right. Forgot about this section. Oh no, on the top path. For no particular reason, I don't even remember which is which. I guess it didn't matter a whole ton. I was gonna have to assume those are death. Yeah, those are death. Interesting thing in Dark Witch 2, it has a whole second set of bosses when you beat all of the main bosses, and there's actually a lot more bosses in general in Dark Witch 2. But the, you know, the Dr. Wily stage doesn't actually have any platforming. It's all just it's just the boss rush and the final boss, of course. Sort of interesting design decision after this. Maybe they got a lot of complaints about this. Like, everything... It's just so satisfying to see a developer, you know, take an idea and just fix everything wrong with the initial implementation. That's why I love this dev in these games. That's something I love about the Senran and Kagura games, the Hyper Dimension Neptunia games. Like, you see a game with a lot of potential, and you're like, but this could have been better, and this, and this, and they release another one, and all that stuff is fixed. And, you know, more frequently, you expect them to just abandon an idea entirely. Aw, crap. And it's just so gratifying when they actually keep to it. I hope this boss isn't actually difficult. As you can see, that not having max weapons will slow you down a lot depending on enemies, and that's why, damn. I died to those before. I should have been more prepared for that. That's how normal gets a lot harder, because you won't be able to breeze quite through quite so easily, and you won't have max installs quite as readily as I do now. Carry down a bit. Oop! So on the subject of difficulty, I rather like that, you know, Dark Witch 2 is basically unfailable, but, you know, you're not going to get, you know, the full experience, obviously, and you're not going to, you know, unlock your special stuff if you do all of that. So I like, you know, and it couldn't have been even too difficult to program the extra stuff, you know. Like, the cheats that Dark Witch 2 unlocks, they're really nice to see, but they would have been very easy to program. Like, one just doubles the amount of heart drops, one, you know, increases more trez, one just straight up makes you invincible. Not really hard to program, just, you know, good for players that are just really bad at the game but want to, you know, be able to beat it. I think this might be the one male character in the game. It's kind of hard to tell. Nah, that's a female voice actor, isn't it? Though, I mean, it's not really unusual for... Generally, women will voice, you know, anyone, any male character under the age of, you know, like, 18 or whatever, because, you know, young male voice actors, they're going to age out of being able to act that. In fact, lots of young girls are voiced by adult women too, just because age changes voices, and that's, you know, and child actors in general, it's gonna be a huge pain in the ass to work with. I'm kind of amazed it ever happens. Certainly wouldn't catch me trying to use one. Like I said before, the boss pattern's harder than the harder difficulty, obviously. But I think you get the point. I've died enough. I don't really... Oh, right. Yeah, so there were two stages here. I think this might be our boss rush. I guess I should look up who's weak to what. Hey, you stole our outfit. Rude. You know you're in deep shit when the level starts with no music. They just kind of throw some pity enemies at you to let you level up your install a teeny bit. Yep, boss rush time. I keep forgetting about blocking. I have decent timing for blocking, but damn it. I just forget it exists when I actually need it. Also, I really like that if you're moving while the diamond missiles spawn, they they get a little out of order and they're a little harder to predict, actually. Also, interesting thing in the second game in the boss rush, the amount of health the enemies drop is dependent on which difficulty. So like in super, super easy mode, they drop two, or they drop three actually. In pretty dang easy mode, they drop two, and in normal they drop one. I assume in the hardest difficulty, they probably just drop none at all. Okay, we're gonna need an easier boss. I don't know who any of you should be all right. Oh wait, no, you do the thing! I'm so bad at dodging that one. I like that attack, though. It's a neat little... Oh! Ow! Ow! Damn it! I was so close to perfect! No! Ah! Oh. Being frozen doesn't actually hurt you, but you almost always are gonna take that hit. Whatever. I have 5 lives, so this shouldn't really be a problem. Sometimes it's better to just... Actually, I probably should just try to block instead of dodge that. But I see that it's gonna hit me. Also, I think the patterns are a bit more set in the second game, so that you... They're a bit more predictable, for better or worse, and they're not necessarily easy to dodge, though. They just have, they're more likely to actually go through with all of their attacks, for one thing, instead of just, she was mostly spamming the same attack there, which probably wouldn't have happened. They also have desperation moves in Dark Witch 2, so, like, once their health gets down to red, oops. So that once they get down to certain health, they'll, Oh, we do get 2 hearts in this. They just fall in the exact same place. What was I saying? Uh-oh. Well, that was dumb. Okay, the desperation attacks, they're usually invincible for at least a bit of the attack. Sometimes all of it. And, usually, you know, difficult to dodge, of course. Sort of the point of attacks in general. Huh. Sometimes they only drop one. That's weird. Oops. Ah. Ah. Hit right. Ah. Whatever. Final boss time. So you are a minstrel.
So ka. Anata, tabigeni no kakko o shite kuni o urutsuite ita no ne.
Can't allow somebody to steal my fashion and live.
Sore nara, mita koto nai ningen demo dare mo ayashimanai shi ne. Zuibun to sashi ga ii no ne. Sara ni sashi ga ii koto ni mou hitotsu wakatta wa. Nani, kandai na watashi ga kiite ageru wa. Koko no iriguchi ni Lazir no kishi ga. So shite anata, tashika Lazir no hime musume ne. So.
Now, for the unassuming clothes, quote unquote, the, you know, magical final boss power gems on the head kind of give you away there. Probably letting Japanese voices play is, I have no idea when the sentence is actually over. One thing I wish more games would do is subtitle. Ah, damn it, I forgot about that. The combat dialogue. Oh, speaking of combat dialogue, there's one more. When I was talking about how good the options are, there's one thing I totally forgot. Zizu actually makes... What even? But yeah, Zizu makes kind of annoying noises all the time she attacks, but you can individually turn off just that sound and leave the dialogue voices on, which is really nice, because I hate having to turn off... oh dang. This is actually way harder without Wing. That sucks. Whoa! I hate to turn off dialogue voices just so I don't have to hear repetitive action voices. So it's really cool that you can do that. Second form time.
かなわぬというのか。貴様、一体何者だ。私、私の名前はジズ。ジズ。まさか神の名を名乗るとはな。いや、その通り、神様なんだけど。ふざけたことを。我が正義を神が裁きに来たとでも。よかろう。ならばその神をも超える力を解放するとしよう。
姫様、おやめください。黙れ。元はといえば、貴様があの小娘を倒さなかったのがいけないのだろう。姫様、それ以上シガーの力を解放すれば人間では扱いきれぬものになってしまいます。うるさい。No。小娘、ジズーだ。名前覚えろ。貴様が神ならばそれもいい。今 私がその神をも超える力を示してやろう。そんなことをしても一時の力を得るだけよ。だがそれで貴様にかない。目的を達成できるならそれでいいんだ。なぜ邪魔をする。なぜ人間よ、わからないのか。人の道を踏み外そうとしているものを 正しい道に導く。神がそれをしないで誰がする。その力解放するがいい。そして外した道を正してやる。これが最後の戦いだ。存分に力を使え。
So I think it's kind of interesting. Our character kind of has a reason for, you know, having magic superpowers. It's, you know, just the god, you know, not a big deal. Final phase, go. Oh, right. She takes damage. She just, she doesn't get the, well, she, just constantly lose power, like they said in the dialogue there. She can't maintain this form for long, so we just kind of dodge. I remember this being a lot harder, more normal difficulty. Like, I'm pretty sure the shots she's firing are supposed to be dangerous. And you can actually destroy those. I think these eventually get wiped. But, whoa! This is sort of an unusual final boss form. It's a bit more typical final bossy thing in the second game. Oh! Forgot about those. Uh-oh. Need to not forget about those. I'm gonna die. Ah, there we go. Basically just enemy spam with some projectiles, you know, keep you on your toes. Okay, we're doing alright. Just need to not get hit by one of those hedgehogs. We'll probably be alright. I guess maybe these don't get wiped. I thought they did, but maybe it's not really that in the way. I don't really want to be all the way on the right where the enemies spawn anyway. Whoa, ah! Oh crap, I have to fight your first form too? Yeah, you actually need to not be at the extreme corner away from her. Because then I can't dodge that one attack. Okay, not too bad, not too bad. Yeah, you can speed through the dialogue if you want. I just, you know, didn't want to do that for the Let's Play. Right. Should be alright for this one. I don't think actually shooting her actually does anything at all. Not sure why she takes these breathers, it's kind of... Okay, hedgehog's coming up soon. Think this wave? Yep. The hedgehogs do not actually do anything until you hit them. But we kind of need to hit them eventually. Oh dang, that thing is in a really annoying spot since it's blocking shots. The other one wasn't doing that. Did it actually take damage from the wind thing for that one thing, or did I just bump into one of the bullets? Ow. Seriously? Seriously? Whatever. Come on. Let me stand in the middle. No! What the crap? Die! I hate that spike thing. For one of my own kind to betray me. Okay, I think she's done. No last ditch? Oh well. Better be sorry. Oh, this isn't voiced. Yes, ma'am. Mom. Meme. You're one to talk. Like she's just completely complacent now that she's run out of power. Just like, I'll give up now. I saw this, but I want to see who does the localization. If it was like, if you don't know, pixel art in Japanese is just called dot art, because you know it's made out of dots. And you actually, in the second game, you can actually unlock, they just call it dots, for the, you know, little pixel art of all the stuff in-game. I just want to see if this lists who localized, because I wonder if it's one of the devs, or who exactly. Oh, I should have mentioned earlier, the devs are actually very responsive to feedback, and they fixed some stuff like almost immediately. Like I forget what problem I even had. I think it was a controller thing. I got my review code like around the day of release, and I had an issue, and I told them about it. And they're like, "Oh, we're already working on it." And later that very day, they had to patch out to fix it, so they're pretty dang responsive. Oh, also, this is one of those games that you can full screen window it. It's a little weird, but like you'll see little bits of edges of the screen that don't full screen quite properly. Oh, we got under an hour. Actually, I'm not sure if that's an achievement in the second game, but I'm not sure it is in this one. It might be a half hour. I think 50 is what we get for that, the normal end. So let's take a quick look at our playing level. So basically playing level is achievements that give you some Siega, which you can buy some effects with. Ah, yeah, this is the one that, you know, you can't use any slots other than speed if you want. The second game has a few extra ones. Yeah, speed bar is 45 minutes. We were actually fairly close to that. I wasn't really shooting for it though. So yeah, we don't have much Sega, but we can. I guess there's a lot less to buy in this one. Oh wait, no, there's a decent amount. Yeah, so you can give yourself more blocking time, more wing, jump height. They have the Castlevania backstep. It actually has invincibility in the second game. I'm not sure if it does in this one or not. I didn't bother buying it yet. You mostly have to do the challenges in order to get more Segas. You can't just, you know, you can't beat the game normally on easy over and over and hope to get, you know, a ton of Sega. You have to actually beat on higher difficulty and stuff. Let's take a quickie peek at the second character. Oh, I like the difficulty descriptions, by the way. Super mode. Overcoming difficulty, so I might be a bigger person. So yeah, we can actually play as Riva now that we've beaten the game. The story is different, and if I recall, your attacks are totally different too. Oh yeah, she has... This is basically the charge attack that Zuzu gets in the second game. It's an optional install skill. Charging doesn't seem to do much at level 1. Yeah, I'll probably do a run-through of this with her. But that's the end of this first playthrough anyway. So yeah, that is Legend of Dark Witch. Thanks for watching.